The Lord says, don't forget. This is a very prophetic and strong warning to somebody. The Lord says, don't forget. You're going through something that they put you in. What you're going through is an accident. The devil used them to put you in it. They use satanic manipulation to get you in that problem, battling that warfare. You wasn't supposed to, and this is for specific individuals. The Lord says, don't forget. Now, whilst you're in the warfare, it is a case where this person, your baby father and his family, is fighting you. Here's a trick about this. They've been fighting you, you know. Yeah, from you was... They've been fighting you from you was with him. Only, you weren't aware them time you was a sinner. Yeah, that mom had a lot to do with you guys not working out. Yeah, she don't want him to know. I mean, she's Christian, ain't she? Is she? No. They worked a manipulation to separate you and your children or put you in what you're going through. And the baby father wasn't even close. He flew in. He's here. I saw them in clocks with his friends going to systems, trying to get some way of getting the child. The Lord has a question. Who is it that saith a thing and it cometh to pass and the Lord God did not command it? Those who get about not in the name of the Lord shall fall for thy sake. You don't know about this manipulation. The Lord is revealing it. The Lord is exposing it. Now, somewhere, because they've made your life hard when it should have been easy, you start one day. Maybe it's best I let him get the child and care overseas. Or maybe it's best I let the child live with his mother because she loves him. Or your mother, the Lord said, don't forget. The Lord said, no, forget, don't forget. Strong warning, don't forget. What was it that made you choose from the get-go not to let them go with them? They haven't been delivered. Don't let your hardship and the system and the laws and everybody tell you, oh, it's best for the best interest of the child. The best interest of the child is to be nurtured with a motherly love, taken care of. If they had not tampered with your finances and your living, you wouldn't even be there because you're ambitious. You're a very goal-getting person. They're the ones that try to sabotage you because the baby father, the ex, he wanted it to be a case where from you left him, he traveled and things take off for him and you go down the drain. But the Lord is not having it. So they went to darker arts. The Lord said, don't forget. Remember that time the baby father beat the child and it was reported? His face, his hand were printed in the child's face. Remember how he beats his children. Remember his rampage. He beats his women. He hasn't been delivered. Remember that time the child, like for my example, my daughter went one summer. I used to send my daughter every summer to the grandmother's house. It stopped a few years ago because she almost got raped there. Almost. And the almost is the only thing that made me never reported it. She came to me one day and said, Mom, can I say something to you? And you don't tell nobody? And I'm looking at her because I'm saying, well, my daughter couldn't want to tell me, say, I know, what is that? What is? She said she was sleeping on her belly and felt someone on top of her that woke her. When she looked, it was her grandmother's husband getting off of her. Leaving the room, and she told her grandmother she never believed, but she told her uncle, and he cussed the man near dealing with him, near doing something. Right? So the uncle believed. From that day, I didn't send my daughter around. And the only reason I didn't report her is because he never got through. If that man ever got through, I wouldn't care. My daughter would have to vex me. But that was about, she was about 10, 11. She hasn't been there 7 to 6 years now. 7 to 6 years, and that is the reason. I never told nobody. But that's the reason why I stopped sending her for summertime. Because she almost got raped there. So when you're going to your hard time, don't forget these things. They're not better. Your mom have the tendency to cuss and put curses and torment people with her words. Your mom. That is why you always think. When you look to the left, you don't think. It's like they won't kill your child, but they would do more. You know that some things are worse than being dead? You have someone who is alive and dead is worse than being dead, because they're alive and suffering the entire time severely. The Bible says, grow a child up in the way that they should go, and even when they're old, it won't depart from them. You know what I mean? The devil is trying, because you're raising them too good, too disciplined. He wants them to go astray and get involved in all of these things. But the Lord protects our children. I decree and declare 21 warring angels fight for our children individually and have victory. The baby father came down because he heard what is going on. He hasn't said anything to you in the vision. I saw him and his friends, they're wearing two Clarks black. And the friend is the one doing everything, and the baby father is hiding. He don't want you to know. He's open to just get the children and cut and leave, and you don't know. But the Lord showed it up, because who is it that said that thing? They haven't changed. They haven't changed. He's here with a woman. He brought down a woman, a black woman, and the woman. In the vision, is like in the aspect, you know, like he wants people to think that his life is better and wants you to feel bad, but really and truly, you don't care about them. Like, this man was the man that made you believe that, you know, he's the only man you ever break up with. And you never miss him, ever. Like, you never reminisce, you never wanted it to go back. It's like you felt you escaped. Remember, he hasn't changed. They haven't changed. Your child was always better with you. They've been fighting you. That ex is the ex that from he left you, he never wanted no good to come of you. It's like he wanted to suit his narcissistic behavior, because he treated you bad. You loved him. He treated you bad, cheated around, did all type of stuff. He left you. That's the funniest part. He left you. He ruined you. He ruined you for other women, and you devastatingly left. And he couldn't believe that from you left, you went better, and you never wanted him back. All his years he spent hoping that one day he would look at you and say, hey, you see, you left me. And my life, the Lord is not going to allow it, and he's not getting your children. He's here. He flew down recently. He thinks you don't know, but the Lord showed me. Tell me to tell you. Don't forget, you're the best person for your children. You love them wholeheartedly. Pray for them. This message is not for everyone. Those who know it's for them will understand. This is speaking to someone who felt sabotaged but couldn't put a finger on it. And is like the baby father. He's always silent when things going wrong and it's public. He doesn't have nothing to say, because he's the one that fired the arrow for it to go wrong in the first place. He wants his children, and he's using the spiritual realm and then coming. And then the other thing, I see them trying to hit the person in the head. I bind every spirit of insanity, and I bind every spirit of madness. And I want you to come in agreement with me right now as I repent. I bind it back to the sender. I bind every spirit of insanity, madness, and confusion back to the sender. Back to the sender. Ever wondering? Back to the sender. I bind it back to the sender. I bind it back to the sender. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Be blessed.